Good afternoon, colleagues. We begin this afternoon's business with time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is the Reverend Martin Thompson, who is the minister at Dalry Trinity Church. Reverend Thompson.
Presiding officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you for this opportunity to address you this afternoon. As a church minister, over these past few months, I have found, as many of my colleagues have found, that by streaming church services, our congregations have grown. More people are listening online than attended our churches physically. It's not yet clear what the significance of that may be, but perhaps we're all learning afresh that the most important things in life are those that can't easily be measured. And you're hearing that from a former teacher of mathematics. As I've spent these past months spending hours on the telephone speaking to people who are feeling isolated and anxious, many of them talk very reflectively about hope, about significance, about meaning in life, and still others speak of a rediscovery of the beauty of the natural world and their daily exercise walks. These are important things, and some of the most important things in life cannot easily be measured. Let me illustrate. You're in a maternity hospital where a young couple recently travelled in some haste. Imagine their growing sense of anticipation and excitement. You can guess at all the preparations that have gone into making ready for this big day. And finally, the baby arrives. Midwife takes this precious bundle and hands her over to the new mother with the words, "I have here for you a bag of bones and biochemical reactions." Now, accurate as that might be, I think most of us would think our imaginary midwife had missed something important. My early training was in pure mathematics, and one day I visited my supervisor with the proof of something, the details of which you'll be relieved to know I'm not going to trouble you with. But I recall being very pleased with myself until the good professor said, "Yes, Martin, but it's a rather ugly proof. When we meet next week, could you bring me something more elegant?" And this was my introduction to the fact that there is a longing even in science for beauty amidst the patterns, something beyond the mere material. Many of the most important things in life cannot easily be measured. And perhaps this is what, at least in part, lies behind what Jesus said, "I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." Or in an alternative translation, "My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life." Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much, Reverend Thompson, for joining us. We're going to move